For years, many doctors and scientists have recommended people to consume milk and other dairy products in order to live a healthy life. But some people are lactose intolerant, which means that unfortunately for them, they can't digest milk. Why is that? Well, people that are lactose intolerant have trouble digesting a sugar in milk called lactose. They lack an enzyme called lactase, which is needed to break the lactose into glucose and galactose, which are both more simpler and smaller sugars. If you don't have lactase in your body, the milk you consume won't be digested, thus leading to different symptoms such as diarrhea, abdominal cramps, or even nausea. Not fun. Becoming lactose intolerant can happen to anyone at any age. However, it's lucky for these people that there are many alternatives to milk, such as soy or almond beverages. There are three different types of lactose intolerances: primary, secondary, and development lactose intolerance, sometimes also known as congenital lactose intolerance. Primary lactose intolerance is the most common kind, which is diagnosed at a young age. People with primary lactose intolerance produce less lactase, which makes the process of digesting dairy more difficult. Secondary lactose intolerance is a little different. It's caused by an injury or surgery, which results in the decrease of lactase production and affects the small intestine. The last type is known as development or congenital lactose intolerance. This is when a child is born either prematurely or normally and with a defective lactase producing gene. So that's just a little on why people are born lactose intolerant and other types of lactose intolerance there are. At the New York Hall of Science, we have more information at our exhibit, The Evolution Health Connection, which explains why some people have trouble digesting milk, what lactose intolerance is, and the geographic history of people with lactose intolerance. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and share it. And as always, if you have any science topics or questions that you'd like to see in one of our upcoming NYSA videos, let us know in the comments below. We post a new video every week, so don't forget to subscribe and keep learning with us.